Hi, Paige. I'm glad you figured out how to do the coupon code. So let me show you about the shipping. I actually had to go in and look it up. I did not develop this site, so I had to go and see what kind of shipping plugin is used and how it's configured. So let me just walk you through all of that. So then you have kind of like the foundation, and then I'll show you how to enter in the specific details for this plugin. And if for some reason this plugin is not working or you do not want to use FedEx, that is what's on this site. Then there are other options. You just have to let me know what you'd like to do. There's everything from, already built plugins for USPS or UPS or FedEx, or there's if you have ShipEasy or one of those other, mega sites that has every option available, those can integrate as well. Or there's even options to do it very customized and somewhat manually, where you create your own shipping tiers based on either the weight or the dimensions or the price or even zip codes or parts of the country. You can ship to some parts and not others and all this kind of stuff. So there's lots of options, but this is FedEx. So let me just show you where I saw that and how I found that. So if you go to WooCommerce and then settings, which I've already done, and then you scroll up at the top and you hit shipping. And then you go right here, this little blue link, FedEx Basic. And as you can see, everything's already set up with account numbers and meter numbers and all of that. It is doing calculations based on pounds and inches. And default to residential address. And oh, it's using FedEx One rates. And it's also only providing the option of FedEx Ground. And that's where you could change this if you wanted to, if there was a different service that was more beneficial to your customers, or anyway, so that should, and then the original postcode, that's another thing to check just to make sure it's calculating correctly. So if you did change something on this page, you would just change it and then click on save, and it would be applied across all the products. So what I did quickly, just as a reference point, is I did put this two-tier hanging unit in the cart, and then I put in an Arizona zip code, and it said the shipping would be 9544 FedEx Ground. And so I wanted to show you how to now, I don't know if that's correct or not, you'd have to kind of look at that. So if you wanted to set the weight and dimensions for these products, you would go over here underneath WooCommerce. There's a tab, products, then go to all products. And of course, you just find it in here. I'm just going to search real quick. Then scroll down to two tier, and I'm going to hit edit. I'm just showing you this because then you can always refer back to it without having to listen to this hopefully not too long video. So if you scroll down a little bit, you'll see this product data section, and you click on shipping. This should be pounds. I can't guarantee it's not ounces, but it says pounds. So if there's a problem and this shipping rate is way too high, it's probably because somebody, I would think that's not too high though, because those are pretty heavy. So you would put in your pounds here, and you would put in your, I don't think, yeah, see length. I'm not going to save this, but I just want to show you width and height. You would just enter those in, and then you would go to the blue button and click update. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to back out of it. So that is how you do that. So you just would do that for every product, and the plugin should handle the rest. So if that's not happening, just let me know and we can go over some options. But while I'm in here, I did notice that updates have not been run, but there have been a lot of updates lately. So I always just double check and make sure it's right. Excuse me, I'm sorry. Hold on just a moment. Make sure nothing's saved there without me knowing. Yep, nope, all good. So what I would suggest you do before you run updates, and if I've said this before, I apologize, but go to settings and then updraft plus backups, and just make sure there's a recent backup, preferably from the same day or previous day if you're running really early. So you just scroll down here and you would see an entry for the current day. Now, I did just change the settings because I noticed this was just saving the database and there are theme files and other things that should be saved. I don't know if that was just an error that I made when I initially set up the plugin, but I, like I said, I didn't develop this site, so I'm thinking it was already here and I just didn't check the settings on that. So after you have your backup, and if you did need to run a backup, you would just click backup now and then click yes to all the options, and it would, once it's done, then you just go up to the updates, either right here, this little almost looks like a recycle symbol almost. Click on that, and then you would just update your database, your WordPress, and then it will finish, and you come back here again, and you update all your plugins. I can't remember if there are any. Nope, I think everything should update fine. I have some clients with paid plugins that they don't want to renew the subscription, so even though they still work, they don't get the updates. So I don't think there's any options like that, but if you could update all those, run those updates, that will protect the site from hackers. So anyway, hope that helps. Thanks.